Hello, we are back, and I'm going to show you another example of auto digitizing. The first video we had a flower design. I'm going to show you something simpler. This is a great use of the auto digitize option. For anything that is very simple, maybe it's 1 to 3 colors, all solid colors and clean lines, the auto digitize option works great. I'm gonna click here and let's look for our file. I'm going to do the palm tree. This is just 2 colors. I'll click next. Very simple. We do have a stamp here, so we can remove that. All right, so I have just the darker gray color. That is the only thing I need to be digitized. Perfect. Let's finish it out. And here we have it. So I always like to use the realistic view. And now this is, it looks like a satin stitch here. The density definitely needs to be adjusted. Right now we're at a 0.5. Usually the program will set that automatically. So I just want to lower this little bit. We can click apply. That looks much better. Another thing we can change is, let's say we wanted to use a different pattern. You have that option. I'm gonna stay with the satin. Now we do have a underlay. So the underlay is the stitch that goes down first, and the program will assign an underlay automatically. In this case, it's parallel, which I'm fine with that. You can see different options here. Let's say a center line, that might work better. And that way the underlay, it will be right in the center. So if for any reason my design shifts, I will not see the underlay. A center line works great with a lot of thinner stitch types. You have a parallel, you have a zigzag. So contour, whether you know that's designated first, you can see here the lines are just around the edge. So if there's any shifting in the design, that line might stick out. That's why I went with a center line. And you can see that change here. Okay. Now let's see how this stitches out, just so we can see what that underlay is. We have a slow redraw. If we click on that, we can just drag this blue bar, and here it shows us how it stitches. And you can see that center line as the underlay. So that looks great. Now, if I want to change the color, we can easily change the color. Since this design was only one color in the image, it will only allow me to choose one color. If I wanted to segment the sun, the palm tree, the little sand pile, I would actually have to really recreate the whole design itself, since this is one unit. So with the auto digitize feature, it can limit your editing options. In this case, we can only use one color here. Let's look at a couple of other features here. We have underlay, push-pull compensation. Now this is a little bit more advanced, so we'll skip that for now. We have connection. Again, these are some more advanced tools. If you have experience with digitizing, you can use those and edit. Let's say we wanted to flip it any which way. We can flip here, rotate. if we need to do that. We can resize it here if you know the exact size. Let's say we want to put this on a hat. Max size on a hat, I would recommend 2.25 inches, really. So anything lower than that, you'll be fine. Let's say, and that's height. Oops. So I'll put 2.25 in height. It will adjust the width in the same way, and then we can apply. Okay. That is using the auto digitize feature, and stay tuned for more videos.